course, that women characters on television are either gray, black or white, not gray. But we forget that we are the medium that's actually given a voice to women. While we have the villains or the antagonists and protagonists in movies, we have the same for women on television. And while men lean a solid support to female-born characters or female characters on television, the same used to happen in films for men. Such a large medium, such a large voice, will it get marginalized with technology? I don't think so. Its challenges actually give birth to fresher, more interesting content. The questions are raised by India and answered by Bharat. So we have a country beyond South Bombay. Unfortunately, we have to be aware of the problems and the... If there wasn't any identification to these stories, they wouldn't be told. Somewhere there is a daughter-in-law having an issue with her mother-in-law, because we have actually a fractured social rule that we've imposed on women. You expect women to leave their homes and go and stay in another house, except the woman of the house. You expect, in fact, if you remember the emblem of Kyunki, it was the keys being given from one mother-in-law to a daughter-in-law. You give your business to your son. That's the way it works in most Indian homes. You give your house to another woman, and she's expected to adopt this house. Then you guys fight for the son of the house. So many mother-in-laws tell their children, their sons, you know what? You know, she doesn't do for you what I do for you. So they both are fighting for the male attention, putting the man on a pedestal. This is a social fracture. We use this to convey a story. We made Tulsi go through a lot of issues by her mother-in-law. And then later on, we showed domestic rape. If you remember, there was a great moment, the Mother India moment, where Tulsi shot her son. 2 crore people watched it on Indian television at that time. ¶¶